I have a few thoughts about some effective ways to manage your online personal presence. And so there are four things that I was thinking about sharing with you today. The first is, number one, is you really need to become socially available. So what does that mean? We're all socially available in our social lives by going to lots of different events. But online, you want to be selective on being socially available. So for example, in my case, I'm on LinkedIn for business. I'm in Twitter for business, and I kind of intersperse that with some personal things, personal items or issues or puppies or whatever it might be. And then I'm on Facebook, and that's definitely personal. And so the key is having a robust profile so people get to know you in different ways, whether it's personally or whether it's professionally. The second is start a blog. If you haven't had the chance to do it yet, read some blogs that other people have written and just give it a shot. A blog tends to be in your voice. It can be a little more casual, a little more informal, and it's generally about a topic that you're passionate about or that you want to share in your expertise. And I think it's fun, and you might even want to try a vlog, which is what I'm doing with you today. It will also give your followers a chance to get to know you a little bit more personally and also see you visibly. So it's fun. This is something new for us, and I think you might try that and find that interesting as well. The other important thing is to make sure that you share some quality content. Any of your followers, whether it's on LinkedIn or Twitter or maybe even Facebook, will really want to read and hear what you have to say. So be thoughtful about the content that you provide. Make sure that it's interesting. Create a dialogue with your followers and people that interact with you and make it more interesting. But they're really looking for quality content. So if you think about yourself online, you're following other people who are presenting very interesting things. You want to do the same because at some point you could become a thought leader in your space, and that's one way to make that happen. And then finally, be consistent with who you are. Don't try to be everything for everyone. And I think it's important for you to speak up, to provide interesting content, but also be your authentic real self. Because I think by then, if you do that, you'll end up having an interesting followership, if you will. And that's what I try to do. I'd love to hear your thoughts on other ways to improve or manage or build your online presence. And I'd love to hear from you.